I think that there are people across the conference, both clergy and laity, who have known that they had a person they could talk to who would love them as much as humanly possible in a Christ-like way.
Well, I went to Huntington after I finished my PhD at Duke, and I applied to church-related schools, particularly Methodist church-related schools, because I wanted to be in a religion department that helped prepare students for seminary.
The legacy I hope to leave is the church is growing, and the church has a wonderful staff and wonderful laity, and they have a wonderful pastor coming in Keith Turman, so I just hope that they'll continue to grow and be a vital church in this community and make a difference.
Looking forward to resting. I'm a wood carver, and I've not done that for a long time because you have to take time. That's a time-consuming process, and I'll be able to do that and just enjoy the beauty of the mountains. I'll be at our cabin up on the South Fork of the New River.
My wife and I joined First United Methodist Church in Montgomery, and I'm still a president of our Sunday school class. I do a lot of teaching there and the church, and I'll continue to do that sort of a thing, as well as I also work with the Alabama Course of Study, which is a course of study that prepares part-time local pastors, and so I will continue working in that area. I'm the chair of the Board of Managers of Alabama.
Being the first woman clergy in so many, lead pastor in all of the congregations that I've served, has been an opportunity to help people see that that God equips and empowers different people, that there's not a particular package that's expected, but each person who's called is called because of their uniqueness, and for me that was the uniqueness of being a female clergy person.
It was a bumpy road for first few years, learning how to teach. It's not as you watch people do it and you think it's easy, then you stand up there and you say, oh my goodness, I need to have all the answers, and I don't have all the answers, and I need to present it in such a way when I don't have the answers to help people find what those answers are. So that was, I had a friend of mine said, you don't really know the subject matter until you have to teach it, and that really turned out to be true.
We will miss our church greatly. I still have responsibilities here at the lake as dean of the chapel, where I plan summer worship and lead Taze services on Monday evening. And we have several activities I'll be responsible for in the fall. So I still have a worship element that I will be participating in. So we'll just have to see. I'm still maybe only semi-retired.
I'm going to support her for many years before she entered ministry. She supported me, so I'm going to support her and help her with the details of her ministry. I'm going to rest. And in good time, I'm confident that God is going to say, now I want you to do this. Because we're still ordained. We're retired, but we're still ordained. And I think we still have ministry to perform. And I'm confident God has something there for me in good time. Not right away.